Hey guys, welcome back to Frenemies. I'm Ian.
I'm Squeamish Beans.
And we're here for another episode of Young Justice. So this is essentially the penultimate episode. We have one more after this. In last episode, we got the team back in the Justice League. We smushed Granny Goodness back together, sure. Which was a pleasant sight.
This is the final episode Eve.
Cyborg got his name, which is cool, and he said Booyah twice. Doubly rewarded.
I hit myself in the nose with an ice cube, and it like rolled into my eye and then into my mouth.
Let's see. We got Violet back. She's accessed more powers, or like been able to use more at once, I believe. I'm not sure if it's going to be constantly. Granny's went to Darkseid and told him that Vandal sent the team. So that's... I'm not really sure exactly why Vandal wanted them to know he's the one that did it. I mean, other than, you know, bragging rights. What's up?
Question.
Go on.
Could she have boom-tubed the entire orphanage?
I don't know. Maybe?
Because I know that's why the lanterns... put in that little thing so it wouldn't boom tube away.
I think they just that thing they destroyed, I think that's what allows them to boom tube the whole thing. Okay. I think. I know it also allowed her to create that field that to hurt them or whatever.
That'd be real unfortunate. She boom tube them to Darkseid.
Yeah, but she was only able to boom tube because she had a father box. But yeah, I think the whole machine is supposed to boom tube the thing. But I don't know what we're going with here, because we still have the whole thing with Terra possibly betraying the team. And obviously Darkseid and Vandal, so that's going to be interesting to deal with. And Infinity
and
Inc.
And Jeff.
And Infinity Inc. The episode before, we saw Jeff, you know, there wasn't really much speaking parts with him. He was more like kind of going through...
A silent movie.
Yeah, but like going through, you know, the crap he's dealing with and also seeing his family and kind of just... taking joy in finally being with his kids and stuff like that. I don't know what we're going to be tackling in this episode. That's supposed to lead into usually like a really energy-packed finale. So let's go ahead and jump into this next episode.
The MetaHuman Youth Center in Taos, New Mexico.
That's Troy Baker again.
Overwhelmed by the sudden influx, but is making arrangements to expand its services or open other branches.
Yeah. I believe it's now time to put our plan in motion.
Of course.
Arranged for Violet to babysit Leon at the Premier building. We'll have a few hours alone to enjoy dinner. I thought I'd take the chance that maybe you've been feeling the way I've been feeling and...
Shh. I have.
But what if he comes back?
He will! This episode.
Huh? Wait. I can't. I'm sorry.
Overwhelmed. He's coming back.
There he is, he's back.
Fred Bug is honored to meet his honor, the mayor, Dabney Donovan.
Feeling's quite mutual. Any friend of Connor's is most welcome in Geranium City.
I think it's safe now.
Indeed. There are no other strangers in town at this time.
Is it Ba'ar's own?
I will drop the psychic illusion.
Or not? Who are you?
Oh my god!
Oh, it's a...
Allow me to reintroduce myself. I'm Double X.
Double X, thank you. I couldn't remember his name.
And
that's
this
cool.
Is the true Geranium City. Or, as I like to think of it, Genomorph City.
Yeah,
2.
That's awesome.
I'd like nothing more than to proclaim your rescue to the heavens.
But that's not politically expedient now.
I'm afraid not. But soon, we simply must be patient.
Excuse me for a moment.
I gotta go report to my secret boss.
Oh, wow.
Why did you bring them? They're not part of this. They're not here for this part. They're here for the aftermath. Assuming we do this at all.
Assuming? Oh, come on.
I've told you, there are limits to my magic. I can't raise the dead.
Raise the dead?
If we do this, it'll leave you devastated all over again.
I never had closure.
Artemis, I love you. But that's something you need to work through, like anyone who's suffered a loss.
No! I need your magic! I will do anything! If you won't help me, I will make a deal with Wotan or somebody, I swear it!
I can't bring a dead soul to Earth. The best I can do is help you meet him halfway.
You gotta tell her that he's willing to let her. Wrong magic killed her. Sorry.
Shiakazin.
Missed ya.
Again. What do you want?
Stay back.
Oh, you can't. Not.
Okay.
And he just took the kid.
Oh, they're in whatever he uses to create
yes,
them.
Yes, the child is perfectly safe here, granddaughter.
Interesting.
Indeed. No need to be modest. I will enjoy watching your continued evolution. Assuming Darkseid does not kill you, since
okay.
You both present great obstacles to his plans.
So, you're really dead, aren't you?
Hey, let's not think about that now, okay?
He didn't say yes!
Wow, things progress fast around here. Oh. Very fast.
Oh, pregnant?
Whoa.
Oh, dang.
Now that's an important development.
Oh no, not the freaking uncle.
Let's be on our way.
But our brother Connor gathered allies who liberated us from that place and that servitude. They brought us to this place. So
Arc.
That we could build a life of our own.
I think we have everything we need right here.
I literally
and for my final trick, I'm going to make the sun appear.
Let's see what else is on, okay?
Coming up next, another wacky episode of Hello, Megan!
Or maybe
Hello,
that's enough TV.
Megan.
It's time for the baby's late night feeding anyway.
Yeah, it's very late, babe. Sun will rise soon.
Let it. I never want to leave.
We are comfortable here, but the dream is not yet achieved.
And perhaps Forager's openness will help the geraniums.
That is admirable, my new friend. Will you do as much?
Excuse me?
You, brother, were freed from Cadmus to lead us to the promised land. But still you hide, which keeps us in hiding. At a time when all metahumans, including Genomorphs, struggle for acceptance, you know you can do more to help. But when will you acknowledge your own place, your own role in the connected world? When will you take the final step to help your own people? Ask yourself, brother, what would Superman do?
I get it. That's one beautiful baby. Is it a boy or a girl?
What?
What's the baby's name?
We haven't named it yet.
It? No. We talked a little about having an it one day, but we could never agree on a name for a boy or a girl. I still like Wolf, by the way. Wolf West, just saying.
For the last time, we are not naming our child after Connor's dog.
What child?
Where? No. No, 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 no! Bruce Lee! Please. Please, 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 hold on. Hold on.
I can't, babe. Believe me, I want to. But I love you too much. I won't let you throw your life away on a memory of what was, or even on a dream of what might have been. I want you to live your life and find love. I'm not sure who could possibly deserve you, but I trust you to make the right choice. We needed this night to finally say goodbye. But the night's ending. And it's time for my Spitfire to go home and live.
Ares Ghost for her.
I did no such thing. I told Artemis I didn't have that power, and I meant it.
Then McGann.
McGann created a playground, an open space in Artemis's mind. But Artemis created or imagined everything she saw and experienced. My ledger domain and McGann's telepathy gave her the chance to work things out for herself. We'll tell her someday. Or maybe we won't.
You've helped me open up, take the next step. And I want you to know, I will always be there for you and Leon.
But
I'm sorry. We're not right for each other.
Whew, what a relief. I felt it too as soon as we kissed. I mean, it's just too weird, right? You're my sister-in-law.
I know.
Well.
Friends?
Friends.
All right.
Frederick Delam, also known as Baron Bedlam, escaped from a Markovian prison and staged a coup with the help of metahumans and members of the military loyal to. No word yet on the status or location of King Gregor Markov. Excuse me, this just in. United Nations Secretary General Lex Luthor had this to say.
No, we will not lift UN restrictions that prevent the Justice League from entering Markovia. This is an internal matter.
Though the Justice League may not intervene, my squad doesn't face those restrictions. This is what I've been preparing for.
I cannot hide in a Beverly Hills hotel room!
Be patient, brother. We tried things your way, now we try them mine.
Markovia, here we come.
Oh boy. That's good. Hey, Wolf. I think that's Craig. That was a good episode. I mean, in all fairness, it was a pretty good episode. But
I understand now why it was called Overwhelm.
Yeah,
we got Wally.
Yeah, I mean,
I am kind of satisfied.
I didn't want to say. there was something I almost said it during that scene, but I was like, no, I don't want to ruin the moment. Austin will probably do it, so I'll wait. So when she's walking through the door, I was like, she walks through the wrong door, actually dies. But luckily that didn't happen. She went the wrong way. But luckily, you know, that wasn't even the case. Apparently she's it was like a sort of an illusion kind of a thing.
Yeah.
But I'm glad though, because if she had chosen, then she would have, you know, died. But it was like her mind, kind of like, since she knew Wally so well, kind of leading her. Like, she knew what she should do, but you know, that inner conflict, you know, you don't want to go forward, and you were kind of She didn't get the chance to say goodbye to him because he died before she could even see him.
He sure did.
So, that was also that weighing on her. I know. 2 years. I know. But I do kind of. I'm pretty sure that's like how what Wally would have actually said to her.
No, definitely. So,
but it's really hard, man. So I don't think we're gonna get Wally.
I swear to God. Well, they're not
gonna. Well, the thing is, they're not gonna. Well, they could. They could just not be a thing. But like, they could. They could not just not be a couple anymore. But I feel like that's like the writer's way of like laying to rest. Like, that's, you know, Wally's not gonna be coming back. We're letting Artemis kind of grieve and or finally kind of get past that and let other people in and stuff.
No.
I refuse. I think Zatanna should have visited you.
Artemis is gonna die, and then Wally's gonna come back.
Or they're gonna. She's gonna die, and they're just gonna be together.
I'll accept that. I will accept that.
Okay. I don't want her to die, though.
Well.
No, I don't want her to die.
It's for the greater good.
Shut up. I'm done with you.
It goes out the way Wally did.
But I just thought that was funny. Like, she's when she comes back to Will and she's like, "I'm sorry, but it's just we don't fit each other." Oh, thank God!
Yeah, yeah.
Oh boy, I did not want to deal with you. It just felt weird. So I am kind of glad of that. Huh? I mean, I didn't necessarily like them as a couple, but it just felt strange. Also, it didn't help that I was holding on to the whole Wally thing.
So, well, yeah, of course, because he's still alive and living in Argentina.
But I do kind of like that they didn't end with them. Like, the kind of almost, not stereotypical, what's the word?
Cliche.
Yeah, thank you. Cliche. Like, you know, she's gone through it, so she's going to get together with this dude.
Yeah, same.
I'm kind of like that.
I was about to say, I was like, boy, I swear to God.
But I like the way that they ended that.
The stupider looking version of Wally Wurst.
All right, that's kind of rude. Yeah, it's true. Not what he is, though. He's a version of Roy.
Yeah, I know.
But and Mark. At the beginning of the episode, we saw that we knew they had saved like all the people, all the kids or the metas that were stuck on the orphanage in 316. Yeah, that's a lot that they had captured.
Bunch of orphans.
Well, they might not be orphans. They take them from the families too, so they probably, some of them might have, you know, family members. Why do you want an orphan so bad?
No reason.
An abundance of Robins or what?
Yeah, Batman's just like.
Calm
down, children.
But they were kind of, they also kind of were exposing Gretchen. But then they're like, some people, some of the like her corporation or whatever she was represented. They're like, it was special effects, you know.
Speaking of Robins.
Uh-huh.
Whatever happened to
Jason Todd?
Yeah.
They didn't address that. They didn't. They might show that next season because this is like they would, I guess they feel like that would be too much and it wouldn't really pertain to what's going on this season, because there's only one episode left now.
Unless something happens tonight.
Could Well, there's still Tim. The other Robin, Tim Drake.
Never heard of him.
Anyway,
he's the lesser Robin. Let's be honest.
Who's not?
Compared to Dick Grayson,
they're good. Like good in their own different ways. Because Tim was always the better detective of the two.
Look, I'm just saying, you had to choose.
I know. Dick will always be my favorite Robin, but it's just I'm not downing Tim like some douchebag. So you know.
Markovia.
Uh-huh.
That's a thing.
Yeah, Tara called Slade or Texas Slade, and so yeah, they were they broke out Bedlam or what's his name? What's his actual name?
Gregor's uncle.
Whatever the uncle's actual name is, I always forget. Baron Bedlam, you know, they staged a coup. You okay? What'd you say?
No, I'm not repeating it.
Did you say Borgle?
No, I didn't. Shut up. You'll find it. No, it's not bad. It is, but it's not bad. It's stupid bad.
Since when do you care about repeating your
stupid? Because it hurt me.
What'd you say?
Shut up.
What'd you say?
You will see it in post. No, I refuse.
Well, I might have talked over it.
I don't care. No, you didn't. You didn't. Okay. You will hear it.
All right. No, but yeah, they broke him out and then he staged a coup because...
Yeah, what's up?
So you do that, but you won't tell me what you had said. Like, how does that not hurt you? Found out, or Tara told them that, you know, he was out of the country, so they were able to stage the coup, and now he's gonna, Brianna and them are gonna, you know, obviously storm the, well, I don't know about storm, but they're gonna go there.
Storm the castle.
And Tara's willing, she's not trying to persuade him, so I'm assuming that's supposed to be part of the whole plan. I'm very worried about, you know, them charging in there, and I don't know what they have planned, and I don't see any good coming from
this. Is where Tara betrays?
I feel like
I don't really see Tara betraying her brother directly, though.
Yeah, but she might see it as, like, it's for the best for her family and them.
Maybe.
I don't know. I don't know how, like, devoted she is to Slade, though. Because in a lot of the different versions, she turns her back very quickly on the team because of Slade kind of giving her the support she needed at a time. Like, even though he did treat her, you know, harshly, but he also, you know,
trained her
and stuff, and yeah,
took care of her.
Made her strong. So I don't know. It just depends on how devoted she is.
He's like the good. He's like this. He's not the stepfather you want. He's the stepfather you deserve.
He's the stepfather you got. Is that really all it is? Yeah. No deserving or needed. And then, what's the dude's name?
Gregor.
No, the chair guy. He just pops up out of nowhere.
Oh. Yeah, just literally shows up and just...
Yeah, he freaking not only a boom tube, but like the boom tube like traveled.
That's horrifying to think about, like that he can just show up whenever.
Yeah, and he's like...
And just grab you and take you away.
Yeah, he's like, go away. He's like, I can't do that.
And then they were having to
speak. And she freaking takes the kid with
her. Yeah, they were having to like speak Xbox to him.
Yeah, they were speaking like the Motherbox crap. Mm-hmm. He like had them in like whatever kind of void or whatever that he created them essentially.
Yeah.
So that was...
Hello, grandchildren. I'm here for my visitation.
Metron. Really? Metron. He's playing him too? Dang, Phil Lamar's playing. Okay.
I'm honestly surprised Troy Baker didn't play him.
Right? He had like three different characters in this freaking episode. This random reporter dude.
Troy Baker here talking about Troy Baker as Super Bowl.
Who's also disguised as Troy Baker. No, but, yeah, so Metron
talking
shows up.
Talking about the new release of Uncharted, where Troy...
But Metron, he's like, okay, yeah, so I'm actually glad I didn't, you know, watch you die.
So I may have messed up.
No, he didn't even say that. He's like, I'm glad to see you, you know, matured or whatever.
Yeah, evolved.
Evolved. And then you guys have become very strong. He's like, I can't wait. I'm very interested to see you know, how you... What hand you lend to this galactic war upcoming? Yeah. Hopefully, Darkseid doesn't kill you, but we'll see. I mean,
but you will get in his way, so he's most assuredly going to
try.
Him.
Yeah, I'm not going to do
shit.
You
didn't know that,
but
because they kidnapped Violet.
Yeah, I'm just going to watch. But I just want to let you know that I'll be watching. Just you know, moral support.
Also, tell that friend of yours to die. You know, the
which
one who
one?
Yeeted me
yeah,
out of my
Connor,
chair.
Okay, that's what I'm... I mean, he didn't seem to care. I mean, it was beneath him.
That's true. He got thrown at and immediately...
Yeah, it was just zoom, like those things you punch and they
yeah,
just
exactly.
come back. He was just like straight.
Yeah, and he got electrocuted and then he was just like, my chair!
Going back real quick to the Artemis and Wally bit, they just keep like... I mean, it was. I liked the way it was done.
Yeah, they
and
just
it was
like
showing...
keep twisting the knife.
Yeah, but it was showing like the life that they could have had if she didn't like. If he just didn't die, or if she didn't go on the mission where she like went undercover with Calder and stuff, like where she pretended to die and then went undercover as Tigress and whatnot. Mm. But you know, then showing like you know they got married and they had kid and
they had kid
child. A child, but. I do like that Wally. I mean, even though it wasn't exactly Wally, it was you know he was like saying, yeah, I know you're wanting to stay here, but you gotta go or you're gonna die, and I don't want that for you. I want you to be able to move on.
Do not become whelmed.
Well, don't be overwhelmed. He wants her to be whelmed. Yeah. I know, it was a title. Yeah, that's what made you like, he's coming back.
Yeah, and I was sort of almost right.
Not quite.
He made a cameo as...
The voice actor did.
Yeah.
But he wasn't really
as
there.
A ghost.
He wasn't really a ghost either. But, maybe... But, no,
I've been teasing him a lot lately.
I know, I think it's just for the fans. Like, saying, like, we know you want him, so here's a bit of him, but here's also...
He's still dead.
Here's also saying, you know... It was for Artemis, but also for like everybody that wants him back. Just like you're gonna have to move on.
It's
we
true.
Want him back too, but this was for the story. It worked, and it would just be kind of like no stakes thing if we just brought him back.
Yeah.
So
I mean, not gonna happen. One more episode.
Yeah, we have one more episode after this,
one
and this is the finale.
Bring him back.
So will you be done with the show if we don't bring him back?
Yep, because here's what's going to happen.
Uh-huh.
They're going to open it up, and he's going to come back immediately and be like, look, that last episode didn't happen. I know you said your goodbyes. Here I am.
Here I am.
That
love
wasn't
me. Well, yeah, but still, I feel like that would be such a throwaway for the
episode. No, exactly. It wouldn't fit at all, and they're not going to do it.
They're not, but... All right, guys, well, that's it for this week's episode. For Young Justice, hope you enjoyed it. If you want to check out the rest of our stuff, make sure you click the button right next to us. If you want to be around for whenever the last episode goes up, go ahead and click the subscribe button. And again, if you want to check out the full reaction, go ahead and check out our Patreon, the button right there, or you can go to the link down below.
Or
take
call
it
toll free.
Sorry. See you guys next time.